Hey up everybody, Magpie Gaming here, and in this video we're going to discuss the preliminary patch notes for patch 0.9 for Escape from Tarkov. Finally we have some full patch notes for this patch. Can't be too long before this patch drops. Information to go with this is we have no actual release date for the patch, but the patch notes are here, so it can't be that far away. Now I must stress that these are preliminary patch notes. I've already done a video on the patch notes a little while ago, and we've just got to say that everything that is within this is subject to change, but the vast majority of what I am going to tell you in these patch notes will make it to the game. So a few things of note are that the Terra Labs map is not going to be in this patch. I think a lot of us were expecting that it would be from the way that they'd been talking about the map. They came out and spoke about the map roughly around the same time as they brought out the other preliminary patch notes for the for 0.9. So people thought, yeah, we're going to get another map with it, but no, it's not in this patch. But never mind, I can deal with that. The next thing is that there will only be a partial wipe of the game. Now what they mean by this is that all of the end level of reputation with the traders will remain the same, but everything else will be wiped. So your rank, your inventory, everything will be wiped, but your rep with the traders will remain the same. Bit of an interesting one, that one. I don't really know how that's going to work, because your rank is kind of intrinsic to your reputation of your traders. So does that mean that from the off you're going to be able to buy the higher level gear? I'm not really sure. Maybe I'm just not thinking about it properly because I haven't had much sleep today, but there you go. But yeah, partial wipe this time. So maybe we're getting to the point now where the game doesn't need full wipes anymore, which would be a good thing. I have in the past understood the need for the wipes, but it could be that we're getting to a point where we don't really need them anymore. So that would be good, because I think, like I say, whilst I understand the need for them in the past, I think the rest of the community does as well. I think we all accept them through gritted teeth. I think we'd really like them to not wipe, but it looks like we could be getting to a stage where they might not do that anymore. So yeah, just a partial one this time. So what's been added in this patch? Well, hell of a lot has been added, and I have to give thumbs up to Battle State Games for putting out pretty comprehensive patch notes for this one. Usually the patch notes can be fitted into one or two tweets on Twitter. This one, not a chance. There is too much in it to put in a tweet. But yeah, I have moaned in the past that the patch notes aren't very detailed, but this time they are pretty detailed. They're still a bit scant in places, but yeah, they give us a really good idea of what we're going to be getting. So first of all, they've added the deal maker scav bosses. Now these are scav bosses that are flanked by other scavs. They're quite blinged up. They have some quite high value loot on them, and they will roughly make appearances now and again. They will be found in and around on the customs map mainly. I think old gas station is going to be one place that they're going to spawn, and these guys don't like to fight, to get involved in firefights apparently, so they will run off and hide somewhere and leave their other scav friends to try and take you on. Now there's not a massive probability that they will spawn on each map. I think it's just going to be now and again. But they're going to be one to hunt because they are going to carry some quite high value loot. Flashbang grenades are in the game. Haven't seen how they will work yet, but I'm looking forward to that. That's a good addition. Smoke grenades, haven't seen how they work, but I've seen suggestions that the smoke will make you cough, so it will give your character away, things like that. I'm looking forward to seeing those. To have some sort of mobile cover to add into a game, I think that's something that's been missing from this game for quite some time. Well, since day one, really. So I'm glad to see those that are being added. Next up, Nvidia highlights have been included into the game so that you can use the highlight system to record, I think it's so many minutes of previous gameplay, so that you can upload that and share that with people. I think that's an amazing addition to have to the game. It's been something that it's lacked and missed a lot, so I'm glad that that one's been put in. Armbands. You are now going to have a set of armbands, various different colours, which you and your squad mates will be able to use, and this is going to be able to make telling, you know, your squad from other people a lot easier. And this is something that I know, this is a hardcore game and they want to keep it hardcore, but sometimes it can be a little bit too hardcore. And if you're playing with four other friends, you've got a team of five, it can be carnage, and a lot of the time team kills do happen. So this is going to be a way of just identifying your teammates, unless the squad that you're fighting against have the same colour armbands on, then it's not going to work out too well. But yeah, armbands just to identify different, you know, identify between your squad and the enemy. Next up, we've got the list of weapon modifications, and I'm going to go through each one of these. You've got the Vulcan MG Scope I Cup. You've got the EOTech Voodoo 1x6 Scope. You've got the Night Force 13mm mount for sight installation. You've got the Armor Sight Vulcan MG Bravo 3.5 Night Scope. You've got the Armor installation base for Vulcan MG 3.5. You've got the Zenith 2U Klesh tactical flashlight. You've got the Annihilator flash hider for the 7.62x39, for the 5.56x45, and for the 9mm. You've got the bridge tight mount for the P226. You've got the rubberized pistol grip for the P226. You've got an E-mod stock. You've got a Salvo 12 sound moderator adapter for carbines, SOK, VOP, air VPO, etc. Got the silencer Co-Salvo 12 sound moderator, the Sig Sauer Romeo 4 reflex sight, Sig Sauer mount for Romeo sight series, 10 inch Alexander Arms rail mount, the 3 inch Alexander Arms rail mount, Polo Sun HS41G5 reflex sight, the Mo pistol grip for AK. You've got the rifle length MK10 handguard for AR-15 and compatibles. You've got 13mm mount Buris produced APPEPR for sight installation. The Buris full field TAC 31x4x224 scope. Combo kit handguard and gas tube for Troy Industries. Raptor charging handle for the AR-15 and compatibles. The Zenit PT-1 stock. The PT stock lock for AKM and AK-74. The Ishmash 7x62x39 aluminium magazine for AK compatibles 10 round capacity. The Bakelite 7.62x39 magazine AK and compatibles 40 round capacity. The Glock 18 C19 9x19 slide. The Glock 18 9x19 barrel with compensator. The Zukov S stock for AK, DS Arms Holland type rear sight for SA58, foldable stock adapter for SA58, extreme duty receiver cover for SA58, the Tapco Saw style black pistol grip for the SA58, the DS 3 inch prong trident for the 7.62x51 flash hider for the SA58, the FAL SA58 7.62x5 120 round magazine, handguard with rail mounts for the SA58, 218mm 7.62x51 barrel for the SA58, you've got an F93 Pro stock, the Last Tac 2 Steiner tactical flashlight, lightweight pistol grip for the AR-15 compatible weapons, the SE5 Express tactical grip, the Fab Defense UAS stock for AK, Tapco Saw style pistol grip for the SKS, Tapco stock tube, Tapco intrafuse polymer stock for SKS, and the Troy Quas mount. So a hell of a lot of mods coming, a lot of them for the SA58. This is a new weapon that's been added to the game. For new equipment, we've got armored visor for the Kiva helmet, the BNTI Carissa N body armor. You've then got Gen 4 body armor in three variants: mobile, assault variant, and full protection. You've got a 5.11 Attack Tech armored plate vest, Black Hawk Commando chest harness, the Anna Tactical Beta 2 combat pack, the Momex balaclava, the LSHZ helmet, the GP5 gas mask, the 6334 ballistic glasses, you've got the GSSH01 active headphones, deadly skull mask, shattered lightweight reinforcement mask, the DevTech Ronin ballistic helmet, the pom-pom hat, I quite like the sound of that, the Miltec Boney, is that meant to be beanie? I'm not too sure. Bandana, you've got the neoprene face mask, you've got the Shammer version 2, USEC cap black, a bear clap black, and then you've got the HICOM Striker ACHHCLLLA helmet. You've got that in olive black, coyote tan, and black. You've got black twice, so yeah, there you go. You can have it in two different shades of black, apparently. And then you've got the armbands. You've got yellow, green, blue, red, and white. So for new weapons, just two new weapons in this update. I did think that there might be more, but for now, it's just two. But like I say, these are preliminary patch notes. So these are subject to change. So more may be added before it's actually released. So we've got the Glock 18C 9x19 pistol, and then we've got the DS Arms SA58 OSW Para. This is a 7.62x 6.6.5.1. And then we've got new quests. There are 5 new mechanic quests, 4 new ragman quests, and 5 skier quests. They've added new loot containers in factory woods and customs. No idea where those actually are right now, but I'm sure that lots of videos will come out very soon that will show these locations. And they've added new paid exits for customs and interchange, so I'm interested to see where these are, especially on interchange, because I've said before that interchange does need more exits, so it'll be interesting to see where those are and how that shakes up the dynamics of interchange, because I have noticed recently when I've played interchange that there is quite a few people camping the extract, and it's made it a little bit harder to get out, so that's going to shake things up now that you'll be able to pay to get out. Obviously the amount of loot that you can get out of this location on, you know, this map is massive, so yeah, I'm interested to see where those actually are. And then we've got some changes that have been made. They've adjusted the loot spawn chances on all maps. This will be to fit in with all of the new loot that is available. Price rebalance for weapons, grenades and weapon mods. They've increased price of powerful ammo. Vests and headsets can now be put into an items case. Finally, that was something that we've been asking for quite a while. They've increased internal size of ammo case, now 6x6. Reduced mouse sensitivity when aiming through high magnification scopes. Changed some quest rewards. They've changed some quest requirements and changed the alpha vest configuration. They've increased the penetration of the SP5 and SP4 and SP6 rounds. Various adjustments of weapons, mods and armor parameters. Improved the behavior of overall individual AI enemies. They've optimized geometry of level objects and improved collection of crash dumps. Additional changes, there's further freeze and stutter fixes, there's further improvements to the anti-cheat work on disconnects associated with anti-cheat, further optimization of the graphical and functional components, preparation for animation optimization phase that's going to be coming up soon, and these are going to be like the new animations that they're going to add for when you do medding and things like that, and then there's various bug fixes. And then there's some more additional issues that have been looked at. They have fixed various glitches. Again, this is where the patch notes generally annoy me, because they don't give much information on these things. I'd like a little bit more information on what they're fixing, but hey ho, there we go. Lack of visibility and audibility of shots from the SR1 MP for other players. Armor now stops the bullet flight correctly if there was no penetration. Fixed incorrect dimensions of certain items and other visual fixes. So I think you can all agree that those are massive patch notes. Some good things coming about in this. Of course, the anti-cheat is still being worked on. I would like to see personally more work put into that, but you know, they have different people doing different things, so to put everybody into the anti-cheat thing wouldn't really make sense, because the development of the game would just grind to a halt. So yeah, I have said that before on the Facebook page and got quite roasted for it, but at the same time everybody's moaning that there's too many cheats, so how do you want to solve it? You know, at the end of the day, do we have more people put on it, or do we just keep the same team doing it? I don't know, you know, that's a discussion that could be have. You know, you could have that discussion all night long about anti-cheat within the game. But yeah, there's some good stuff coming into it. I like the fact that there's only going to be a partial wipe. Or okay, everything's getting wiped apart from your trader reputation, but trader reputation does take a long time to build up, so I'm glad that that's not getting wiped. Smoke grenades, flashbang grenades. I've noticed that there is a gas mask added. If you were wearing the gas mask, does that mean the smoke isn't going to affect you? I don't know, we'll have to wait and see on that. As I say, this patch isn't released yet. I would assume that it won't be too far away though, now that we have full notes. Could be that by the time I get this video up it's been released, or it could be a couple of days away, if not a week or so. I know before we've had large patch notes for patches, and it's then been a week or so before we've actually got them. I think 0.8 was a good example of that. I think patch notes were released around 2 weeks before the actual patch was initiated, so but hopefully it will be around very soon. So thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Take care.